Charles Darwin University is named after someone who never went there. And it's surprising because from Macassar, for hundreds of years, many, many people went there. And in preparing for this scientific symposium, I decided to look into the question of the Macassans coming to our north coast. The north of the Northern Territory was called Maregi, which in Macassarese means dark skin or black skin. And I wondered how long people have been coming, and I looked at all the books. And it seemed to me it depended on what you studied and what your discipline was as to what question you might ask yourself. And so I looked at the different questions I asked. Historians, linguists, anthropologists, archaeologists, and me as a lawyer, I asked my own questions. The historians have decided that the Macassans didn't really come to the north coast to fish for tritang until about 1740 and even possibly as late as 1780. And that is because the question they ask is, when did they come for tritang? Anthropologists ask the Aboriginal people, when do they believe that people first came to the coast? And they talk about two lots of people. A light-skinned, fair people who came to the coast not to fish for tritang at all, but to stay there and to grow rice and to make metal and to weave cloth. And this is a very different story to the Macassan fishermen. So the anthropologist comes to a different conclusion and would say we're probably talking about 1650 or something like that. And then you get to an archaeologist like Paul Tasson, who goes and looks at Aboriginal rock art, and there's a great deal of it, showing Macassan-type boats, the prow of Paduakan, for example. And he was able to carbon date wax underneath the paintings, wax on top of the paintings, and he would say to you, ah, well, the earliest date I can go back to is about 1664. What was happening around 1664 here in Macassar? Well, in 1667, there had been a war on between the Sultan of Goa and the Sultan of Borneo, and the Sultan of Borneo defeated Goa with the help of the Dutch. After the Sultan had been defeated, the Bugis Macassarese people were very unhappy. They signed a treaty, but everything was unfair. And many of them, who were formerly farmers, turned to the sea and set off looking for a new life, a better life. And there's no reason to suppose that the paintings that have been discovered on the rock walls in Arnhem Land, in the Northern Territory, weren't of vessels of the Bugis, Macassarese, fleeing from here in Macassar, fleeing Goa, and settling down for a long time. And then there's a big gap. And then we know that the Macassan fishermen suddenly came because the market for tritang in China had become huge. And so when you ask the archaeologist what the time was, and then you ask the historian to have a look again, you come up with a date that means that people from here and other parts of the archipelago have been coming to the Northern Territory for well over 400 years. Then one asks another question, a different question, about what happened with these exchanges. And we know that there are mixed families of Bugis, Macassarese, that Aboriginal people came and lived here for extended periods of time and had families here. So there is this very great connection. But the Macassans stopped coming in 1907 for tritang because the government didn't want them there anymore. And so they stopped, but paintings of Macassan vessels have continued to this very day. There are 800 words shared between Bugis, Macassarese, and the Yolngu Aboriginal languages of Northeast Arnhem Land. And so there's this very strong connection. And that was reflected in 1988. When a vessel was built here, a prow of Paduakan, and it was sailed to Darwin, and it's now in our museum, our maritime museum in Darwin. And last year, and we saw the sailors this morning, for those who are at the symposium, a canoe, a sun-deck canoe known as Blue Sky, Liru-Biru, sailed into Darwin, and it too is in the Maritime Museum in Darwin.